I guess so in this tutorial, this is going to be a very natural look, and I am first starting to apply a little bit of the Master Fix all over the face. And now the foundation that I'm using today is the Hard Candy Glamour Flash Foundation in the color Medium. Now granted, I did add turmeric to this foundation, so it's a lot more yellow than it would actually be once you get it. I am blending this foundation really well with my Kabuki brush. This is the Sigma F80. For my under eye concealer, I'm using the Maybelline Master Conceal Concealer in the shade Light. I'm using a wet sponge. This is the Real Technique sponge, and I feel like this is just a really good way to really blend the concealer and make it seem a little bit more natural and just blend it a little bit more. With the same wet sponge, I'm just going all over my face to make sure that the foundation looks very well blended and natural. This is the Essence I Love Stage eyeshadow base. This is probably one of my favorite eye primers, and it has a very skin tone color, so I like it because it's very pigmented and it takes off a lot of the discoloration on my eyelids. So I'm using this palette by Milani. This is the Earthly Elements. I love this palette so much. It is extremely warm. For those of us who appreciate those warm shades, man, this palette is just beautiful. I'm using that shade that you noticed that I picked up. This is the brush 217 from Buying Coins, only 99 cents. I recommend it 100%. So I am just putting it all over the crease and blending all over. I'm going all the way towards the inner corner as well. This is just a technique that I think really works for my eye shape as well. Now I'm going in with my very famous Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contour Palette in the shade Caramel Toffee. I'm using that yellow shade to kind of highlight a little bit of the, or give a little bit of light to the look on the, just on the eyelid. And then I will put it also to highlight over the brow bone. And I'm just over here blending to make sure that there's a really good transition between those colors. Right now I'm using the Jordana Easy Liner for Eyes in the shade Lavish Brown, and I am just going to line the very close to the lash line in the outer corner of the eye. Over here, what you see me do is just use an eyeshadow brush. This is kind of like a smaller brush, but it's just to make sure that that shade or that color is blended, that eyeliner, and not that it doesn't look too defined, that is more blended. I'm going back to that palette, back to that same shade, and I am lining the lower lash line, or just applying a little bit of shadow under the lash line, but all the way from the outer corner to the inner corner. Right here, I'm just brushing my eyebrows to kind of prep them and put them a little bit more in place for lining. I'm using my favorite liner. I just really cannot stop using this. This is a L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer in the shade Brunette. This is probably just the best pencil I've ever used, and ever since I got it, I just cannot use anything else. I have not used anything else. Right now I'm using the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Plumper, which is exactly what I use along with the Brow Stylist Definer. It's just the perfect combination. I just can't help it. Right now I'm going back with my Wet n Wild palette. I'm using that yellow shade and a wet sponge, and I'm actually applying the powder to seal my to set my concealer underneath the eye and also to give it a little bit more brightness. Today I'm using the Maybelline Lash Sensational Luscious Mascara, and that is what I'm using on my eyelashes. Going back to that beautiful palette. I just can't help it. I'm sorry, guys. This is what I'm going to use to contour today, and I'm actually using the Real Techniques blush brush. This is a new brush that I actually started using for that, and I feel like it picks up so little product and it makes the contour look so natural. I just used the very tip of that brush, and I just feel like it just gives it such a blended and natural look. I love it so much. This is the Kiko Bronzing Powder in the shade Terracotta. It is way too warm for me to use it as a contour shade, and it's completely matte. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use it kind of as a very warm, natural shade of blush and just put it all over my cheeks. But I couldn't leave it just there, so I'm using the Kiko Soft Touch Blush in the color 100 Cookie. And I'm just putting this a little bit on the apples of my cheeks and bringing it a little bit up. Right now I'm just really blending very well. I want this look to be very natural. This is the Model Co Lip Enhancer Illusion Lip Liner. I received this in an IPSY bag, I think, and I really like it. It's just a very nude shade, and it just really helps when I line my eyes with my lips with this to make sure that the liquid lipstick that I'm using, which is the NYX Lingerie in the shade Ruffle Trim, if I'm not mistaken, goes on a lot smoother, and the application at the edges, it's a lot better. If I try to do it without a lip liner, it just looks messy and I tend to go over my lines and it's a big mess. The final thing is just to spray a little bit setting spray. This is a Master Fix. And that's it, guys. I hope you liked it. See you in the next one. Bye.